الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، إن الحمد لله مالك تعالى وأستعين به وأستغفره وأستهديه، وأعوذ بالله العلي العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. Welcome, inshallah, dear brothers, inshallah, dear sisters, we're still in our journey with the Holy Quran, the chapter of the thunder, Surah Al-Ra'd, inshallah. We'll cover tonight from the verse 7 to verse 11, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. A'udhu billahi minash-shaytanir rajim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَوْ لَا أُنزِلَ عَلَيْهِ آيَةٌ مِّن رَبِّهِ إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُنذِرٌ وَلِكُلِّ قَوْمٍ هَادٍ. This verse, number 7, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling out us about the disbelievers of Mecca. How they يعني, insist asking Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for miracles and for too many questions. وَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَوْ لَا أُنزِلَ عَلَيْهِ آيَةٌ مِّن رَبِّهِ إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُنذِرٌ وَلِكُلِّ قَوْمٍ هَادٍ. The disbelievers of Mecca say, why has no sign been sent down to him from his Lord, such as those sent down to other messengers? Those nations still disbelieved in Allah despite seeing the signs. Allah tells the messenger that your job is to warn them only. And every nation has had its guide whom calls them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We can understand, I have a note here, my tafsir Nur al-Bayan. If you were to show them the signs, if they were firm in their disbelief, they would not believe in Allah anyways. Subhanallah. Let's see. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, Almighty Azza wa Jal, in that verse number 7, in the chapter of the thunder, that disbelievers of Mecca, they used to ask Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for too many signs, too many ayat, too many miracles. And they denied the Quran al-Kareem. And the Quran al-Kareem, it is the main miracle of the miracles of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why Allah sent the Quran in Arabic to the people of Mecca or these people in Arabia? First of all, the Arabic language, it was their Arabic, it's their language, their balagha, their adab, their bayan. For that's why, subhanAllah, even them, they used to make poems and they used to hang it on the wall of the Kaaba just to debate with each other. And if some one of these tribes, they used to have a poet man, subhanAllah, they used to be like, they used to have ego and they used to be proud of him, subhanAllah. We have that poet from our tribe and all of that, subhanAllah. Tafakhur. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he sent the Quran to them, they denied. And they said, no. We need a miracle like the miracle of Musa alayhi salam, Prophet Moses, and the miracle of Jesus. And they did not even pay attention to too many miracles which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes with. For example, not blessed the Quran sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he puts his fingers and subhanAllah, the water was gushing, يعني, subhanAllah, from his fingers sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with less food, he used to give it to the army, subhanAllah. And al-ghamam, the big cloud was subhanAllah above the shade, above the head of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, shading him from the sun. And also the palm trees, trunk where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was standing and he was delivering the khutbah and he left that palm trees and he take a minbar, a pulpit and was crying and everybody was listening to the sound. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said about the Holy Quran, Al-Quran al-Kareem, غِنًا لَا فَقْرَ بَعْدَهُ وَلَا غِنًا بَعْدَهُ. Al-Quran al-Kareem, غِنًا لَا فَقْرَ بَعْدَهُ. If somebody has the Quran, this is, subhanAllah, this is the best. There is nothing better than the Quran. وَلَا غِنًا بَعْدَهُ. If somebody has lots of money or whatever Allah gives him from this material things or this life in this dunya, subhanAllah, Al-Quran is still the best. That hadith مرفوع عن أنس رواه الدارقطني. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم القرآن كافيني. القرآن is enough for me. عليه الصلاة والسلام. القرآن is enough for me. فالرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم oh, Arab people, he is one of you. He used to speak Arabic like you. And he never learned from any teacher, صلى الله عليه وسلم. ولم يجلس إلى معلم. He never say poems before, عليه الصلاة والسلام. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he sent the truth on his tongue, حق على لسانه. And the Quran al-Kareem said that in the chapter of Jonah, I explained this surah before, verse number 16. He said to them, and Allah mentioned that على لسان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, قل لو شاء الله ما تلوته عليكم ولا أدراكم به فقد لبثت فيكم عمرا من قبله أفلا تعقلون. Guys, if Allah will, I will not recite this Quran to you and you will never gonna be aware of it. And I stayed my life عمرا من قبله before I give you the Quran 40 years I've been amongst you. أفلا تعقلون, don't you have sense? سبحان الله. That's why جعفر بن أبي طالب, the cousin of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he went to Abyssinia, he was talking to Najashi, the king of Abyssinia, and he said, Allah سبحانه وتعالى بعث فينا رسولا نعرفه. Allah سبحانه وتعالى sent a Nabi, a prophet. For us, we know him, عليه الصلاة والسلام. We know his family. We know his amana, his trustworthy. And وقد كانت مقامه عليه الصلاة والسلام بين أظهرنا 40 years. Before he get the message, he stayed with us for 40 years. We know him very well. He cannot lie. عليه الصلاة والسلام. That's why some of them, they said Rasulullah was عبقري. He was genius. And those who said that, المستشرقون, non-Muslim people, they said Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was very genius man. I disagree with this. Even if he was genius, I disagree. I cannot say Rasulullah genius, عبقري. Rasulullah was a Nabi, a prophet, and messenger. Because when they say Rasulullah being talented or genius, they try to take you from direction to different other direction. What is the direction? To believe in Rasulullah as a messenger or a prophet, to believe that he was genius. Yeah, I cannot say Rasulullah, astaghfirullah, was not. But also, no, I don't want to, I dislike this word. I don't like it. I can say just Rasulullah, he was a prophet and messenger. That's all. Because let's see, repeat all of us, Rasulullah was genius, 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 genius. After a while, خلاص, you forget about the prophet and messenger. He was genius, that's it. See, they take you, they try to take you from different direction. طيب. If Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يعني he being talented alayhi salatu wa sallam, first of all, he died, his father died when he was still in the utter of his mom, her womb. يعني he was yatim even before he was born alayhi salatu wa sallam. After that, when he was 6 years, his mom died, Amina. After that, his grandfather, Abdul Muttalib, the one who used to take care of him, died. Allah. And he, subhanAllah, all of these later when he became a prophet, his uncle Abu Talib, the one who used to take care of him, died. Means all of these great people in Mecca, with or without any reason, they die in front of him, alayhi salatu wasalam. Tayyib, if somebody being talented of something, certain job or something, why he's waiting until he became 40, he showed to the people. If somebody being talented, like from 15 to 20, people can see what he's doing. I'm talented, I cannot hide it. Why he did not make that and bring the Quran when he was 20, for example. That's why Rasulullah, he's Rasulullah, alayhi salatu wasalam. These people, they did not know what to say. Sometimes they denied the Quran. They said, no, we'll not believe in the Quran. Quran is not a miracle. We need a miracle like according to this ayah. وَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَوْ أُنزِلَ عَلَيْهِ آيَةٌ مِّن رَبِّهِ. We need sign, a miracle like Prophet Moses or Prophet Jesus. Okay. And sometimes they said, like Surah Al-Zukhruf, verse number 31, they said, no. We believe in the Quran. We don't have any problem with the Quran. So what is your problem? Our problem is Muhammad. We need somebody else. A big man from Mecca or Taif. Quran said that. وقالوا لولا نزل هذا القرآن على رجل من القريتين عظيم. أيوة. What do you want, guys? Do you believe in the Quran or not? What's your problem with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم? هم, these people themselves, they cannot deny the Quran Kareem. Their problem, it was Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. That's why Allah سبحانه وتعالى, he used to send the miracles to the prophets. For example, here, Sayyidina Musa, his people, they used to do magic. They were magicians. They knew it. They were expert in that. That's why Sayyidina Musa, he came with his staff and he make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed them these miracles to defeat them, whatever they used to know. Sayyidina Isa, during Prophet Isa, Jesus, during his time, people, they were good in medicine, tib. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him that, by the permission of Allah, how to bring people from death to life and to cure those who were ill during his time. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the one who can say, I will send the miracle or not. You cannot tell Allah what to do. We have to understand this. But your job, ya Rasulullah, you are just a warner. قال إنما أنت منذر ولكل قوم هاد. You are just a warner, ya Muhammad, to warn these people ولكل قوم هاد. فالله سبحانه وتعالى, he knows when and how and why he can send the miracles to the people. Nobody can tell Allah what to do. سبحانه وتعالى. This is very important, جماعة. Let's see verse number 8. And I have my tafsir Nur al-Bayan here. I have a title for this ayah. Allah is all knower and He is able to do all things. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah alim and He is able to do everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in verse number 8, Allahu ya'lamu ma tahmilu kullu untha wa ma taghidu al-arhamu wa ma tazdad wa kullu shay'in 'indahu bi maqdar. Look at this ayah. Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah knows what every female bears. He knows whether it will be a male or female and whether he or she will be successful in life. He also knows whether the pregnancy will end before term or the child will be born premature or exceed full term. Everything has measure with him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now let's explain this ayah. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declared that, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's just a warner, he's just a munzir. And these people of Mecca, they asked for miracles just to, they think they're going to stop Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even if he brought miracles to them, they're going to deny him alayhi salatu wa sallam. And they're going to stay in their disbelief. Allah knows what was in their mind, their intention. But he knows more than that, alayhi salatu wasalam. What did he know? Allah said, he said, Allah knows what every female bears. He knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala, what every and each female bears or carrying, male or female. مَا تَغِيدُ الْأَرْحَامُ وَمَا تَزْدَادُ. What's in the utters or the wombs of the females. He knows the time, the term of pregnancy. Until the, subhanAllah, the baby or the janin will be born. He knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not just that. Maybe somebody gonna tell me, Sheikh Jum'ah, what are you talking about? Nowadays, doctors, they can tell you. No, doctors, they can tell you if male or female after the pregnancy. They cannot say anything before that. Not just this. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, what is the meaning of ma taghidu al-arhamu wa ma tazdad? Whether he or she will be successful in life or not. He also knows whether the pregnancy will end before term or the child will be born premature or exceed full term. The funny thing here, let's see what the imams are saying. You're going to laugh right now. But I'm going to, for amanat al-ilm, because I have to tell you, because this is knowledge. And I have to tell you, even if I don't believe it. طبعاً, of course, 100%, even Abu Hanifa said, or Shafi'i said, or Malik, or Ahmad ibn Hanbal, they said, I disagree completely about this. And if anyone of you has different opinion, call me, my number is there. Okay. Okay, what is تغيض الأرحام وما تزداد? زيادة في المدة, the term of the pregnancy, or the baby or can die, subhanAllah, they can, the lady can make portion or can die before even he was. Or تغيض الأرحام تزداد, maybe somebody, subhanAllah, he has like instead 5 fingers, maybe 7 fingers, right? Or 2 head. instead of one head, now we see them now. It's just that extra. Or تغيض maybe has four fingers or one eye. صح? What is in the womb? طيب. والرحم, the womb, it is where is the janine, the baby, staying on the term of الحمل. طيب. The time of الحمل, maybe the baby will, subhanAllah, the lady she's carrying two or three until eight. I see in the social media that lady in India, she delivered eight babies, mashallah, like rabbits, or more or less. Yes. Or the term of الحمل, pregnancy, could be 6 months, right? تغيض, نقصه, decreasing. Or 7 months, yes, she can be. Or 8 months, I agree until 8 months. Or the normal is 9 months. SubhanAllah. طيب, let's see what Imam Abu Hanifa said. Imam Abu Hanifa said, the term of pregnancy, the term of pregnancy is 2 years. Can go to 2 years for the human being. She's not a cow or buffalo. I disagree with this. I never seen a lady she's pregnant for 2 years. Imam Shafi'i said the term of the pregnancy can go for 4 years. They give you some deals. And I laugh, subhanAllah. Of course, I disagree with this. Imam Abu Hanifa said the term of pregnancy sometimes can go to two years. Yani a lady, she can be pregnant for 2 years. I disagree. Imam al-Shafi'i said the term of pregnancy can go for more than 4 years. What? Did you see in a lady she's pregnant for 4 years? طيب, Imam Malik said the term of pregnancy can go more than 5 years. Imam Malik said that. Allah. And according to this ayah, تنقص وتزيد, تغيد وتزداد. Allah. طبعا, of course, I disagree with this completely. The maximum we see women, they can be pregnant for 9 months. This is what the Quran said. 6 months, I agree, yes. 7 months, yes. 8 months could be. But to be pregnant for 2 years, like what the Imams are saying, Shafi'i said 4, Abu Hanifa said 2, Imam Malik said 5 years. this is funny, Saraha. في كتاب, in the book, in the name of that book, حلية الأولياء, they said, الإمام الضحاك ولد لسنتين في بطن أمه. His mom was pregnant for him for 2 years. Is that right? And they said Harim ibn Hayyan al-Abdi, and he was working for Umar ibn al-Khattab. His mom was pregnant on him for four years until he became old. That's why they call him Harim. Of course, this is funny. Don't worry about what I'm just said right now. This is what I read in the books. I'm not trying to put the imams down, but this is what I read. All of this fake. Allah A'lam, the imams, they said it or not. I don't believe this. We know that the brig, وحملوه, وفي, the Quran said what? وحملوه وفصاله كم? 30 شهرا. The Quran said that. What did the Quran say in Surah Al-Ahqaf? It's his pregnancy, the baby. And breastfeeding, 30 months. Quran said, forget about this now. What the Quran said, 30 months. What's 30 months? Allah said in Surah Al-Baqarah, والوالدات يرضعن أولادهن حولين كاملين. What is حولين 24 months? The breastfeeding. Quran said, Surah Al-Baqarah, 24 months plus 6 months could be the pregnancy, but 30 شهر, 30 months. See, that's why Umar ibn Khattab, when a lady, she delivered after 6 months, delivered the baby, Umar ibn Khattab said, أقيموا عليها حد لتير, deliver the baby and kill her. حد. And سيدنا علي بن أبو طالب said, no, أمير المؤمنين, wait, didn't you read the Quran? Yes, a lady, she can deliver the baby after 6 months. And her husband was thinking she made zina before the marriage. That's why she waited the 3 months. Maybe the husband was thinking she made zina 3 months before the marriage. That's why she delivered the baby after 6 months from the marriage. But the Quran said it could be possible, يا جماعة. وكل شيء عنده بمقدار. المقدار, it's the كم, how much, الكيف, how, the time and the place. Or مواهب مؤهلات. Everything has measure with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In what? The amount, the kayfiyya, how, the time, the place, and all of that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Luqman, verse 34, إِنَّ اللَّهَ عِنْدَهُ عِلْمُ السَّاعَةِ وَيُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْثَ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْأَرْحَامِ. Indeed, Allah, He has the knowledge of the hour, the rain, and He knows what is in the wombs of the woman. Tama, the doctor nowadays, they said, we can know, is a boy male or female. And they, subhanAllah, this
those who are claiming that we have knowledge and we can know, they cannot tell me he's going to be tall or short. Can they tell us they're going to be tall or short? Can they tell us he's going to be stupid or smart? They cannot. Can they tell us he's going to be happy or sad? No. Can they tell us he's going to go to Jannah or hellfire? No. The job of the tabib, they call him MD, not a doctor. I'm not calling the tabib doctor. Doctor is somebody has PhDs. Even if he's tabib or in the يعني, whatever field. But it's the tabib, just MD. He can just take some of the liquid around the baby and he can make his analysis and he can tell from his knowledge he's going to be male or female. That's it, nothing else. After the pregnancy, not before the pregnancy, he cannot tell anything. فذاتس واي بقى somebody بقى يتفلسف ويقول لك يا عم بلا قران القران سيد لا يا حبيبي القران سيد everything يا حبيبي انت your knowledge very limited you can tell me male or female that's it after what the pregnancy that's it nothing else but you cannot tell me go to Jannah or hellfire happy or not tall or short stupid or something his rizq livelihood you cannot say anything you don't know nothing about this Allah the only one he knows that's why سبحان الله سيدنا زكريا he knew that said الله said يا زكريا إن نبشرك بغلام اسمه يحيى before even the غلام comes to سيدنا زكريا he said I give you glad tidings زكريا of a boy his name is John without any analysis without any taking any liquid around the جنين or anything even the جنين became الله سبحانه even before the جنين الله told the زكريا عليه السلام الله سبحانه وتعالى يا جماعة the doctor cannot tell us about the color of the skin of the baby. Male or female, is that stupid or not, happy or not, or how many? They cannot tell. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one who created Adam without father and mother. He is the one who created Eve with father without mother. He is the one who created Isa, Jesus, alayhi salam, with mother without father. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created all of us with a mother and father. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when His qudra is there, capability, He will say, kun fayakun, be and it is. That's it, done. Kun fayakun. For that's why, when Zakariya alayhi salam, he went to Maryam, he found the food of the winter and the summer time. Ya Zakariya, Maryam, anna laki hada. From where you get this? When he entered the mihrab, he has the key, Zakariya alayhi salam. Nobody allowed to enter to Maryam except Zakariya. He has a key. Nobody allowed. He cannot. He found the food. Who gave you this? She said, هو من عند الله. Allah gave me this. قالت هو من عند الله. إن الله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب. If Allah wanna give rizq to somebody, He will give it to him without any accountability. Allah will give it to him. That's why. سيدنا زكريا as a Nabi, who was begging Allah for a child, he got the boy and he said, off. If that happened with this young lady, Allah is giving her without any accountability, what about me? He went to the mihrab and he started praying and he asked Allah for a son. Malaika, they came and they gave him glad tidings. Now we have to understand. طيب. Let's see verse number 9, very fast. عالم الغيب والشهادة الكبير المتعال. الله أكبر. عالم الغيب والشهادة الكبير المتعال. Allah is the knower of the unseen الغيب and the seen الشهادة. He is the great, the high, al-kabir, the great, the greatest, al-muta'al, the highest, subhanahu wa ta'ala. I say greatest and the highest, why? Because Mr. Fir'aun, he said, أنا ربكم الأعلى, I am higher than the God of Musa. لا يا حبيب, لا يا حبيب, you're nothing. الله أكبر, الله أكبر, Allah is the greatest. يبقى الله سبحانه وتعالى, عز وجل, everything has measure with him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing hidden from him. Whatever is happening to you in the past, in the present time, in the future, he knows about it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. فالله عز وجل عالم الغيب يعلم ما يغيب عن الإنسان. He knows what is hidden from you. وكذلك يا عالم الشهادة. He knows the seen and the unseen. عالم الغيب والشهادة. الكبير, Allah said الكبير. What is الكبير? الكبير, one of the names, one of the names of the beautiful names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said كبير وأكبر. What is the difference? To work in your job, and to maintain the earth, this is something kabir, something good. But when the azan comes for salah, it is not kabir. Which one is kabir? The azan or the salah or your work? The salah, that's why he said, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Af'al al-tafdeel. Not Allah kabir, Allah kabir. No, work is kabir. It's okay. It's good to work. To maintain your life, kaza. Because if you did not work, ya jama'ah, brothers and sisters, you will not have money to get food. And if you will not eat, you're going to be homeless. And if you will be homeless, how can you pray? How can you make hajj? How can you make zakah? How can you make sadaqah? To maintain your life and to maintain the earth. That's why the work in your life is something kabir, something important. But it's salah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling you for salah, is calling you for salah, he say what? The azan, what did say? Say, what did the azan say? Allahu kabir or Allahu akbar? Allahu akbar. Aywa. Tayyib. If the work to maintain your life, to get the food for your family, to maintain the society, to maintain everything, to have money to go hajj or to give sadaqah or charity or to eat, to clean yourself, to have house, shelter, to have masjid, to make your salah in it, it's wajib, right? It's mandatory. This is kabir, something kabir. طيب, what is the rule of al-fiqh said? وكل ما لا يتم الواجب به وكل ما لا يتم الواجب إلا به فهو واجب. If the wajib will not be perfect, or will be perfect, if the wajib, the mandatory, something mandatory, will be perfect with something, that something which is I'm talking about, it's wajib too. يعني if الصلاة واجب, right? You cannot pray without eating food. You can stand outside. To work, to get food, it's wajib too. It's mandatory. You cannot. That's why Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, كفى بالمرء إثماً أن يضيع من يعود. It's a big sin for a person to destroy his family. طيب. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, يا أيها الذين أمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله. When the salah, the caller of صلاة الجمعة is calling you to go there, run, hasten, go to the masjid. يبقى this, to go for الصلاة الموقوتة, صلاة الجمعة. طيب, after you finish your salah, what should you do? You go from الكبير, from الأكبر to الكبير. What is the أكبر? The مؤذن is calling الله أكبر, الله أكبر. Means you come to the salat الجمعة. This is أكبر. When you finish, you go from الأكبر to الكبير, which is the work. What did Allah say? فإذا قضيت الصلاة, after finishing the salah, what should you do? اقعد على قهوة, فانتشروا. انتشروا, تقعد على القهوة وتلعب دومينو. You play cards in the coffee shop. You leave your family hungry, يا أولاد اللذينة. وتقول لك, يقول لك يا أخي ده بافرتي. يقول لك يا أخي we don't have food to eat. أنتوا لسه ناس ليزي, مش عايزين تشتغلوا. اقعدوا على القهوة العبوا له دومينو طول الليل, والعبوا كوتشينة, وناموا الظهر. واديله وقول لك أنا يا أخي ده it's poverty. We don't have work, we don't have any situation is so bad. أنت ما بتشتغلش. You don't have right even to ask for food. You're not working, you're not doing nothing in your life. والله العظيم, يعني makes me sad when you see in our country somebody what شحط كده 25 years ولا 30 years he's still taking his مصروف from his mom and his dad, his money, bucket money to what is this? What is this? And يقول لك يا أخي situation is bad, our country is so bad. ده يا أخوي situation is not bad, you are bad. That's why you have to go from الأكبر الصلاة, when you finish صلاة فانتشروا في الأرض وابتغوا من فضل الله واذكروا الله كثيرا لعلكم تفلحون. Work. يبقى you go from الأكبر الصلاة to الكبير. طيب before الصلاة you go from الكبير to الأكبر اللي هي الصلاة. يبقى الله أكبر, leave everything for the صلاة. طيب القاعدة الشرعية وكل ما لا يتم الواجب إلا به فهو واجب. Work is واجب. Yes, because الصلاة it's أوجب. Very important. طيب والله سبحانه وتعالى هو المتعال. الله is so high, the greatest. منزه ذاتا وصفة وأفعالا. Nobody similar to Allah. ليس كمثله شيء. ولا صفة كصفات الله ولا فعل كأفعال الله. Our action is not Allah, like Allah's action. Our attributes is not like Allah سبحانه وتعالى attributes. Our ذات, we are not similar to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Sometimes واحد يتفلسف يقول لك إيه؟ يقول لك إن الله خلق الإنسان على شكله. استغفر الله العظيم يا رب. متخلفين. بقول لك الله كرييت ذا هيومن, ذا هيومن لوكس لايك هيم. استغفر الله العظيم. يعني الله has knows like us. استغفر الله العظيم, استغفر الله العظيم. الله يا جماعة ليس كمثله شيء, هو السميع البصير. Nothing similar to Allah. We believe Allah has eye, has face, has feet, fist, has leg, has قبضة, has. Allah said in the Quran, whatever the Quran said we believe it. Has eye, has سمع, hearing, sight and everything, but without how. Nothing similar. بلا تعطيف, بلا تعطيل ولا تكييف ولا تمثيل ولا تشبيه. Without similarity. ليس كمثله شيء. Whatever the Quran said, we believe. Whatever the authentic Sunnah said, we believe. Without how, that's it. طيب, verse number 11, inshallah. سواء منكم من أسر القول ومن جهر به ومن هو مستخف بالليل وسارب بالنهار. See this ayah, verse number 10, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, it is the same to Allah, whether you counsel your speech or you declare it openly or whether you hide your actions in the darkness of the night or you act freely in the brightness of the day. It's all similar to Allah. Again, verse number 10, Surah Al-Ra'd. سواء منكم من أسر القول ومن جهر به ومن هو مستخف بالليل وسارم بالنهار. والمستخفي, the one who's hiding himself in the darkness. والسارب, the one he's freely, openly, he's doing his action in front of everybody. فالله سبحانه وتعالى, he is the knower, he is the عالم of the seen and the unseen. In secret, Allah سبحانه وتعالى knows about it. Allah said in Surah Taha, الرحمن على العرش استوى. The most merciful is above his arsh. How? Imam Malik said, without how, we believe. استواء الله ليس كاستواء البشر. The way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's above his arsh, is completely different from us. Nothing similar to Allah. Brother Samir Kamoun, he's sleeping with khanzab above his chair. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he sit above his kursi, is completely different from us. Don't put your imagination and illusion and illusion, وعمل لي بقى فيلم هندي, Indian movie, we don't need Indian movie, you know, to put a lot of spicy and تقول أيوة because, no يا حبيبي, إحنا we don't have to have this. Allah is completely different from us, we have to know that. ليس كمثله شيء, وهو السميع البصير. Nothing similar to Allah, he's the السميع, the all hearing, البصير, the all seeing, سبحانه وتعالى. سواء منكم من أسر القول ومن جهر به ومن هو مستخف بالليل وسارب بالنهار. فالله سبحانه وتعالى يستوي في علمه تعالى من أخفى القول منكم ومن جهر به. ده آية. له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. Everything in the heavens and the earth belong to Allah سبحانه وتعالى عز وجل. له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض سبحانه وتعالى. وما بينهما and what is in between belong to him too. وما تحت الثرى and what is after the ground, under the ground. What is تحت الثرى? ثرى the dust. What is under the dust? Go in the depth of the earth until you go to the core of the earth. It's all belong to Allah عز وجل. Whatever about كل عالم الايه, عالم الملكوت. What is the كل علم, عالم الملك. الملك, whatever your eye can see, this عالم الملك. And عالم الملكوت, whatever is hidden from your eye, this كل عالم الملكوت. Under the ground, above the heaven, that you don't know nothing about this. This كل عالم الملكوت. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said. For everything for Allah سواء, it's equal to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. If you make any action during the darkness, in the night, secretly or front of the people, Allah سبحانه وتعالى, he knows about it. Last verse with me, يا جماعة. طيب, when we say this ayah, Allah knows everything about you, don't let Allah see you while you are disobeying him. Maybe somebody can hide from people and they're doing something haram. طيب, didn't you think Allah is watching you? He's a shaheed, he's a raqib, he knows everything. Even if you do it in the middle of the darkness, alone, nobody is seeing you, but he's seeing you. And this is the level of al-ihsan. What is al-ihsan? أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه. فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراه. To worship Allah as if you see him, but we can't see Allah, but he sees you. سبحانه وتعالى. This is the level of al-ihsan. Let's see. This ayah number 11, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, this ayah, I love it so much, and you're gonna be happy now. But this ayah, it's for your own benefit. It is not against you. These guys, they are talking outside, disturbing me. This ayah said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Ra'd, verse number 11, لَهُ مُعَقِّبَاتٌ مِّن بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِ يَحْفَظُونَهُ مِّنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ. يعني من أمر الله؟ يعني بأمر الله. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ وَإِذَا أَرَادَ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ سُوءًا فَلَا مَرَدَّ لَهُ وَمَا لَهُم مِّن دُونِهِ مِن وَالٍ. Beautiful ayah. يا الله. Creed, عقيدة, faith. يعني you are not alone يا جماعة in this world. You are not alone. Allah did not create you just go. No. Let's see the meaning, then we'll explain to you. For each person, there are angels guarding you before and behind you. They protect the person by the command of Allah. بأمر الله. They protect you by the command of Allah. And also keep count of his or her actions. اللي هم الحافظة. They are writing your حسنات and your سيئات. Good or bad. Allah will not change. Focus about this. Allah Almighty عز وجل will not change the good condition of people as long as they do not change their goodness themselves into disobedient. يعني more you will be good, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep that good conditions for you. If you change to be bad, Allah will change it too for you. Allah will change it too for you. Their goodness themselves into disobedience, if you change from being good to bad, Allah will change it for you too. However, when Allah wills to punish people, there is no place to escape to from Him. That's why Allah said, فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. Huh? فَفِرُّوا, الفرار in Arabic means when you see a lion, you run away, flee from him, right? But when Allah used this word with him, He said to him, not from him. Because you're going to flee from Allah to whom? Ya miskeen. From Allah to Allah. That's why I say, فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. For that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذَا أَرَادَ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ سُوءًا فَلَا مَرَدَّ لَهُ. Nobody can stop that punishment if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to punish you. You cannot escape that punishment, Allah said. And they will not find anyone to protect them besides Allah. وَمَا لَهُم مِّن دُونِهِ مِن وَالٍ. See this ayah before we make the iqama. Allah said, لَهُ مُعَقِّبَاتٍ. له يعني for you, not against you in Arabic. When you say brother Samir, come on, له $100 tonight. I'm going to give $100 tonight. له for him. فالله said له معقبات يعني for you, يعني something benefiting you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the ayah, when you read this ayah, you have to be happy, يا جماعة. Just be, wait for me 5 minutes, inshallah. What is معقبات? معقبات, angels. يتعاقبون فيكم بالليل والنهار. They are coming day and night. They are around you from your behind, between your hands, from your front. What they are doing? They are protecting you. Like Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, when he was migrating with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abu Bakr, sometimes he used to go, he used to run in front of Rasulullah, he look. And then he used to go back behind him, you look in the back. Sometimes he go on his right side. Sometimes Rasulullah said, Ya Abu Bakr, what are you doing? He said, Ya Rasulullah, atarassad al-tariq. I'm looking, maybe somebody want to kill you or something. Look, imagine, look how much Abu Bakr al-Siddiq used to love Rasulullah. In the migration, somebody give them some milk. And he said, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, I give it to Rasulullah. And Rasulullah was drinking until I was satisfied. How much love Abu Bakr al-Siddiq love Rasulullah. Rasulullah was drinking. قال قد شرب رسول الله حتى ارتويت. الله أكبر. حتى ارتويت أنا. Rasulullah was drinking until I was satisfied. As if the one who was drinking. See, how, that's why the iman of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq is equal to the iman of the whole entire ummah until the day of judgment. How much he used to love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For Allah, out of his love to you, he's sending mu'aqibat. Mu'aqibat, malaika, angels, they are guarding you. The scholar, they said, the same angels who are writing your good deeds and your bad deeds, they are the same one who are guarding you. This is their job too. Maybe you're gonna hate them. Don't hate them, because they are writing your bad deeds. No, wallahi. Ya akhi, sometimes the ulama, you like the scholars, even don't hate your enemy. Do you know why? Because your sadiq, your friend, he could be a munafiq, a hypocrite. And he's telling you, brother Samir Kamun, you're the best, you're the best, you're the best, you're the best. They make his head like this. And until he became blind, and he gonna do a lot of bad things. Because he gonna think he's big. And some people, they're like this. More you talk highly about them, they love you so much. Okay, talk highly about me, I'll give you money. Some people are like, that's stupid. But do you know your enemy? Sometimes he's benefiting you. Do you know why? Because he's watching you, and you're gonna take care of this. Yes, my enemy is watching me. Let me take care of my action. I will try not to do any bad things, because my enemy, they are hunting me. See? So that's why, if you see, if you remember when he was at the school, they bring a man to watch you, not to cheat or during your exam, right? Maybe you hate him. You say, go away. I want to cheat. You know? Remember? I want to cheat. And you hate, why you hate him? Maybe you are the best in the class and you get 100 score. MashaAllah, you are the best. If everybody gonna cheat, means you've been studying for nothing all the year. Everybody gonna be equal to you, see? But that's why you are making good deeds all of your life. Malaika, they are writing your hasanat. If everybody khalas gonna, without hasanat, without sayyat, we're gonna be equal there, let me do whatever I want now. Why I've been making salah and the zikr and all of this ibadat, and everybody gonna go to Jannah like me, and you're gonna get my level. Oh, la, ya habibi, it's not like that. So you don't have to hate these angels, they are your friend. But of course, if you make something good, they're going to write your hasanat. That's something for you. If you make something bad, this is against you. This is because of you. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَا يُغَيِّرُ اللَّهُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُوا مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ You have to change from being bad to good. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you all good things. Subhanallah. For that's why writing hasanat, good deeds and bad deeds, this is for your own benefit. That's why Allah said from the beginning of the ayah, lahu, lahu, it's for you, mu'aqibat. طيب, إن الله, we'll end this, إن الله لا يغير ما بقوم حتى يغير ما بأنفسهم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers, before He created us, He created this universe for us, this world for us, this earth for us. And He subjugated everything for you to serve you. Maybe somebody can ask, طيب يا شيخ, if Allah loves us like so much like that, and He's sending angels to guard us and all of that, what about these earthquakes in Turkey and Syria, and these people, they are hungry, this certain place on earth, why these people, they are killing each other's war and all of that? Allah is telling you already, إن الله لا يغير ما بقوم حتى يغير ما بأنفسهم. If you change from being good to bad, He will be bad with you. And sometimes He's slapping your face with some earthquake, sickness, something to let you wake up. It's a awakening call from Him. عبرة وعزة. See? Because you are making sin. I will tell you something before we end. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never punish anybody. He come to that limit to punish like this. Until people, they show their sin openly. They disobey Allah openly, and they will be proud of their sin. And there is no shame. Like what they are doing now. When somebody said prostitution under our law system, and they give tarkhis for the prostitution, being licensed, means that they are challenging Allah openly. Al-khamr, the same. Al-zina is the same. And you're telling me why Allah is doing that, ribtilat, and He's sending angel to guard us? No. Mahuluk, Allah said, يَحْفَظُونَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ. The angels, they're never gonna dispute with Allah, they're gonna contradict Allah. Do you know what's meaning min amrillah? By the order of Allah. The angels cannot stand against Allah, even if they are guarding you. For that's why if Allah wants to do something bad to you, by the order of Allah, and the angels gonna obey. خلاص, they're gonna take their hand away because the order is coming. This is your destiny, right? This is the meaning. يحفظونه من أمر الله, يعني بأمر الله, بأمر الله, by the command of Allah. Don't tell me the angels gonna tell Allah, no, you asked us to guard this guy. No, they cannot dispute with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فأول بأمر الله, by the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I give you the ayah, Surah An-Nahl, verse 112. وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا قَرْيَةً كَانَتْ أَمِنَةً مُطْمَئِنَّ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us that example about that village, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, آمِنَة, being secured, مُطْمَئِنَة. يَأْتِيهَا رِزْقُهَا رَغَدًا. They get their rizq, provision easy, mashallah, from everywhere, من كل مكان. what happened to them? فكفرت بأنعم الله. They denied. They were not grateful to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. What happened? فأذاقها الله لباس الجوع والخوف. Allah سبحانه وتعالى give them the garment. The garment of what? الجوع, hunger. And the خوف, the fear. Because of what they used to do. See? Be good, Allah will be good with you. You change from being good to bad, Allah gonna change and He gonna hold His ni'mah. We have to come back to Surat al-Mustaqim. I'll finish. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this ayah in Surah Taha. فَمَنِ اتَّبَعَ هُدَيَ فَلَا يَضُلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى. When Allah send the Eve and the Adam and the Shaitan to the earth, He said, I will send messengers to you. I'm gonna make a comment now, I know. فَمَنِ اتَّبَعَ هُدَيَ فَلَا يَضُلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى. If you follow my guidance, you will never be miserable. But if you give your back, you neglect the Quran al-Kareem, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِ فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ. His life will be miserable. That's why, brothers, if you see these fawahish, shameful acts, zina, haram, disobeying Allah openly, wait for the punishment in everywhere like what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying. جزاكم الله خير.